My name is Mwebaze Abdul Karim. I'm from St. Joseph Kabgayi, and I'm one of the lucky participants of Pioneer Olympiad of this year, 2017. I'm dealing in the category of public speaking, and specifically, I'm going to be talking about the environment in general, some of the ways our environment is being destroyed or degraded, and the measures we can take in order to prevent this. First of all, the word environment is not new to the most, if not all of us. We hear it many times, and we're still hearing it. Environment, first of all, means our surrounding, as you all know. It means all the plants and animal species that surround us. But what we call that time when you're standing on your balcony or on top of a hill? Think of that view you have, and also that time when you start to take a tour around your town or city. All you see is the environment I'm talking about. The environment is so huge, and it's the natural world in which we live in with the plants and animals. Our planet, that is Earth, is our God-given environment. But as far as categorizing is concerned, we mainly have two forms of environment. We have the natural environment, which mainly involves God's creation, like plants, animals, plus with the humans. But thanks to man and his critical thinking and creation, that we have what you can call the man-made environment or the artificial environment, which is mainly our modern society today, where we find different machines, cars, mobile phones, computers, different buildings and infrastructures. We may have different environments depending on the different parts of the world where we come from, but our task remains the same, which task is protect and conserve our environment. Let me ask a question. Do you think our environment is being destroyed or conserved? The answers to this are many, but tell me, as an industry set up, how many trees are planted? As an industry is releasing dangerous exhaust gases like carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide and ammonia gas, is there going to be planted a tree which will absorb some of these bad gases like carbon dioxide and release for us the oxygen which we need for our daily lives? Okay, tell me what will happen if this tree is not present. An industry will give us jobs and we shall earn some money. So what's the time of wasting time? What's the use of wasting time planting trees, you say? Our eyes are blindfolded by finances such that we cannot see the harm we are doing to our environment. Tell me, do you think our environment will be the same, or this planet will be the same after two or three decades from now? Yeah, think of the planet which shall live for those who will come after us. How will it be like? Global warming is rising very rapidly, and not forgetting the greenhouse emissions. Vehicular pollution is very high, but all you care about is transport, okay? Yes, development is important and we need it, but do you think the environment is less important? A farmer using manure feels not satisfied or feels it's just useless when he knows that there are other fertilizers and chemicals he can use to get a high harvest. But knowing that these will leave the environment, will reduce the quality of the soil, making it infertile in the near future. The population is also rising each and every day, and the high birth rate is responsible for that. And this is being a very big burden to our environment. So what's the way forward? The best way you can protect and conserve our environment is by recycling everything after we're done using it. How many of us remember to take the plastic bottles and polythene bags to their recycling units after using them? Yeah, I sound frustrating, I know, but you know the easy way out is just to throw it on the ground or just leave it where you've used it. Okay, these materials, for your information, do not decompose, and I guarantee you, if not recycled, they'll do very good damage to our environment. Water consumption is also very high, and if we try to reduce it, we shall be doing some good to our environment and to ourselves as well. Water is becoming scarce each and every day, and in the future, water will be as precious as gold, and we don't want that to happen. So try to reduce the number of baths you take daily, and also, while brushing, don't leave that water flowing, at least close that tap. Try to also reduce the use of electricity. You know, it's very high, but try to reduce it. Try to reduce the time of hours you... the number of hours you spend on those electric appliances, and after using them, at least turn them off such that you can reduce the amount of the usage of electricity. But think of this, you will also be reducing some money to be paid for electric bills. Yeah, it's not bad after all. Okay, quit smoking. Actually, it's needless to tell you about the dangers of smoking, both your health because you know it's a source of many illnesses. But it's not only your health you're destroying, you're also damaging our environment, because the smoke from that cigarette damages our environment and also affects us when we inhale it. So it's not only your health, it's the health of other human beings and the environment. But do you think that cigarette is worth the environment and your health plus the health of other people? Well, I assure you there's nothing you lose when you decide to quit it and place it among the documents of your bad history. Plant a tree somewhere, somehow, in that compound outside your office, in the small yard at home. Plant a tree. This tree, for any information, will give us the oxygen we need and to purify the air around us. Grow vegetables. Actually, many farmers grow these vegetables using pesticides and other chemicals. But if you try to grow your own vegetables without using these ingredients, then you will be doing some good to your health and the environment as well. And last but not the least, talk about it. Find time with your friends to talk about the damage which is being done to our environment and how we can prevent it. At least it would be better if many people were aware of what is happening to our environment and how we can prevent it from happening. After all, this is our home, the home of our children and grandchildren. So let's make it better for at least those who will come after us. Thank you.